Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. Let's draw an orbital picture for ethylene, or sometimes called ethene. So here's our molecule, ethylene. Ethylene has two sp2 hybridized carbons, and we're going to draw the orbital picture for this. And the star of this picture is going to be the pi bond. So remember, this carbon-carbon double bond consists of a sigma and a pi bond. And so the pi bond is really what's going to stand out in this picture. Remember, we make pi bonds through overlapping p orbitals. So let's be very specific about what p orbitals we're using. And that's why I've drawn this axis on the left. So we have this the s, the px, py, and pz. I'm going to choose to make our sp2 hybrids out of the px and the py. So we get three sp2 hybrids, and these are going to sit in the xy plane because we use the px and py, and we'll have a leftover pz orbital. So let's draw this and try to be true to our axes. So here's our first carbon, our left-hand carbon. It's going to have a sigma bond to another carbon. That sigma bond's made by overlapping sp2 hybrids. And since we're trying to represent this in the xy plane, we need to make sure it's kind of oriented with that plane. So we'll have one of our sigma bonds to hydrogen, kind of like that. And the other one on the left-hand carbon, sort of like that. And we're trying to represent the trigonal plane of our sp2 hybridized atom. We'll do the same for the right-hand carbon, carbon 2. And now let's deal with our pz. Our pz that's left over has to be on this vertical axis. So we'll have the pz on this carbon. And if we want to overlap with a p orbital on the right-hand carbon, we better use the same p orbital. So these are both our pz's. Pz on the left, pz on the right. And for our orbital picture, we simply connect the two ends of these p orbitals. And you might say, oh, but now you have three lines connecting those carbons. Those top and bottom lines are each half of a bond. So collectively, they make the full bond. And if we've drawn this right, it should be clear that the molecule sits in the XY plane, and then the PZs poke through that plane. So when we draw these orbital pictures, we don't worry about what's the positive end of the orbital or the negative end of the orbital. We simply draw the shape of the orbital. And that's how we draw an orbital picture that includes a pi bond, in this case for ethylene.